is coming to town.
Santa is coming to town. Santa is coming to town. Santa is coming.
You better watch out.
Okay. Welcome. Welcome to the Christmas Eve program. We're going to start out by singing Joy to the World.
Joy to the World.
First verse only?
Yeah. Yay. Does that sound good?
All right.
Scripture from Helaman chapter, should we have an opening prayer? Yeah. 14 verses 3 through 8. Yeah. Does anybody volunteer to read that?
I can do it.
Do you have it?
Not yet.
Now,
but I
will. This is Samuel the Lamanite prophesying to the Nephites about the coming of Jesus. So, Helaman chapter 14 verses 3 through 8.
Okay. And behold, this will I give unto you for a sign at the time of his coming. For behold, there shall be great lights in heaven, insomuch in the night before he cometh, there shall be no darkness, insomuch that it shall appear unto man as if it was day. Therefore there shall be one day and a night and a day, as it were one day, and there were no night. And this shall be unto you for a sign, for ye shall know of the rising of the sun, and also of its setting. Therefore they shall know of a surety that there shall be 2 days and a night. Nevertheless, the night shall not be darkened, and it shall be the night before he is born. And behold, there shall a new star arise, such an one as ye have never beheld. And this also shall be a sign unto you. And behold, this is not all. There shall be many signs and wonders in heaven, and it shall come to pass that ye shall all be amazed and wonder, insomuch that ye shall fall to the earth. And it shall come to pass that whosoever shall believe on the Son of God, the same shall have everlasting life.
Okay, thank you. Now we're going to have Natalie sing us a solo, Away in a Manger.
Do you have a primary songbook somewhere?
Somewhere.
Let's see. Turn around to your audience.
Isaiah chapter 53. I can give you this phone. But and then we're going to have O Come All Ye Faithful from Peter and Rebecca.
Then what?
Okay. Wait,
so Isaiah chapter 53, this is a prophecy from Isaiah about the Savior. I want you to listen carefully, guys.
Who hath believed our report, and to whom is the arm of the Lord revealed? For he shall grow up before him as a tender plant, and as a root out of the dry ground. He hath no form nor comeliness, and when we shall see him, there is no beauty that we should desire him. He is despised and rejected of men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief, and we hid as it were our faces from him. He was despised, and we esteemed him not. Surely he hath borne our griefs and hath carried our sorrows, yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions, he was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. All we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned every one to his own way, and the Lord hath laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. He is brought as a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before her shearers is dumb, so he opened not his mouth. He was taken from prison and from judgment, and who shall declare his generation? For he was cut off out of the land of the living. For the transgression of my people was he stricken. And he made his grave with the wicked, and with the rich in his death, because he had done no violence, neither was any deceit in his mouth. Yet it pleased the Lord to bruise him, and he hath put him to grief. And when thou shalt make his soul an offering for sin, he shall see his seed, he shall prolong his days, and the pleasure of the Lord shall prosper in his hand. He shall see the travail of his soul, and he shall be satisfied by his knowledge. Shall the righteous servant justify many, for he shall bear their iniquities. Therefore will I divide him a portion of the great, and he shall divide the spoil with the strong, because he hath poured out his soul unto death, and he was numbed with the transgressors, and he bare the sin of many, and made intercession for the transgressors.
Nervous for you because I can't think of
it.
Third
verse, last verse,
or the last phrase.
Triumphant, O come, he, O come, he. beautiful.
Why was there some in Spanish?
God.
Okay.
Because he speaks Spanish.
Now we're going to have a Christmas poem from Jared, and then we will all sing Angels We Have Heard on High.
Angels We Have
Heard on High.
That's one of my favorites.
Okay, why don't you stand up for us, Book?
Okay. All right, Remember Christmas by Valerie L. Plowman. Red reminds of the blood he split to wash away and cleanse all of our guilt. White is for his actions most pure. Through sinless perfection he did endure. Green is for the life eternal we can obtain through our Lord supernal. The star shines like the one so bright that twinkled above the first Christmas night. The fir tree is for many things, the tree of Jesse, the father of kings, and for the needles pointing to the Lord, that little babe we all adored. The wreath shows one eternal round, the begin of the Lord cannot be found. The lights remain us that his babe is the light of the world and born to save. The candy cane is for the crook, not one sheep or lamb the shepherd forsook. The Christmas bells we love to ring proclaim joy, the birth of a newborn king. These symbols remind us that we, more like the three wise men all now should be, earnestly seeking to find the new babe who humbly lay in a manger laid.
Yeah, that's
Jared.
Good.
Very nice, thank you.
All right, all three verses of Angels We Have Heard on High.
Angels, we have heard on high, sweetly singing o'er the plains and the mountains in
chapter 3, verses 5 through 10, and then Emily and I will be singing Where Shepherds Lately Knelt. You want to read it?
No,
it's okay.
Mosiah 3, 5 through 10. All right, I need to read it aloud so everybody can hear, okay. Now this is from King Benjamin. This is something that was revealed to him by an angel. All right, King Benjamin was...
That's a long scripture.
Yeah, and you're going to read all through 10. You still want to? Mm-hmm. Okay. 5 through 10.
Now, did you be serious about it?
Yeah.
Don't be silly.
For behold, the time cometh, and is not far distance, that the power of the Lord upon...
Omnipotent?
Omnipotent. Who reigneth. Who was, and his, and is, from all eternity to all eternity, shall come down from heaven among the children of men, and shall dwell in a tabernacle of clay, and shall go forth among us men, working mightily miracles, such as healing the sick, raising the dead, causing the lame to walk, the blind to receive their sight, and the deaf to hear, and curing all manner of diseases. And he shall cast out devils, or the evil spirits which dwell in his heart, in the hearts of the children of men. And he shall he shall suffer
temptations,
the pain of body, hunger, thirst, and
fatigue.
Even more than man can suffer, except it be unto death. For behold, blood cometh every pore, so great shall be his anguish for the wickedness of the abominations of his people. And he shall be called Jesus Christ, the Son of God, the Earth, Father of Heaven, Earth, the Creator of all things from the being, and his mother shall be called Mary. And lo, he cometh unto his own, that
salvation
might come unto the children of men, even though through faith on his name. And even after all this, they shall
consider
him a man, and say,
wash your hands,
he hath a devil. And shall
Scourge
him, and be...
Yeah, if you're touching my cookies.
And shall
crucify
him. And he shall rise the third day from the dead, and behold, the strength...
He standeth
to the judge the world, and behold, all these things are done, that the righteous judgment might come upon the children of men.
Thank you, Nadia. Very good job.
That was a lot of reading.
That's all.
All right, Henry, where do you want to stand? Okay.
Ready?
Stirred, but there is room and welcome there for me.
Scripture.
Alma.
Alma chapter 7, verses 10 through 12.
Really?
And then,
did I read it?
Well, no, you just read one. Then we'll have some time for testimonies, if we like, and then we'll finish singing Silent Night. So, Alicia, would you mind reading Alma chapter 7, verses 10 through 12?
We already sang Silent Night. I already sang Silent Night.
This is part of Alma's preaching to the people in Gideon. And this is one of my favorite scriptures about the Savior.
10 through 12?
Yes, please.
And behold, he shall be born of Mary at Jerusalem, which is the land of our forefathers, she being a virgin, a precious and chosen vessel, who shall be overshadowed and conceived by the power of the Holy Ghost and bring forth a son, yea, even the Son of God. And he shall go forth, suffering pains and afflictions and temptations of every kind. And this, that the word might be fulfilled, which saith, he will take upon him the pains and the sickness of his people. And he will take upon him death, that he may loose the bands of death which bind his people. And he will take upon him their infirmities, that his bowels may be filled with mercy, according to the flesh, that he may know according to the flesh how to succor his people according to their infirmities.
One of the things that the church this time around has done the Light the World campaign, which Michelle has helped make sure that every night we have looked at what it was as a family and talked about what we've done for the Light the World campaign. But I can't remember a Christmas that I felt closer to the Savior than this one, and because the campaign has been doing things each day to try to be like the Savior. And the more that we've tried to do that, the more that I've just found that I love Him and want to worship Him. And I know that Jesus is our Savior. And Dad said a few years ago that Jesus was teaching him how to love, and I feel like I've been feeling that as well lately, that He's been teaching me how to love and what that actually means. And I love Him. And I'm so grateful that we get to celebrate Him together and that we come from a household of faith. And that we have kinship with you all in worshiping Him and remembering Him and honoring Him and trying to be like Him. And I love you all too. And I say that in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen. Daddy, you've only cried once since I was born.
Wow.
At Grandpa's funeral.
Oh.
Which was 2 years ago.
Would any of you like to share a testimony or thoughts about Jesus or something to do with Christmas? Natalie, you can go first.
He died for us. The end. I want to go.
Okay.
All Christmas is about how He was born, and it's the most meaningful holiday to me because it's when the person who would die for us because He loved us so much was born.
Thank you, Emily.
Tomorrow's Christmas Day.
I'm grateful for you, Aaron. I'm grateful for your letter. It's very meaningful. I don't know I have a lot of good memories of Christmas. Because I was just talking to Rebecca about this in the car. But sometimes it feels like we're going through the motions spiritually and like our actions, but I never felt that way with Christmas. I always felt like it was raw and sincere. And it was probably one of the times when I've grown closest to the family and to the Savior. I've been thinking a lot about the birth of Christ and about how when the shepherds were in the field and how the angels, they came and they sang. And I'd like to think that we were among them. I'd like to think that we were those angels singing glory to God in the highest. Because the plan of salvation was in the works, because he'd been prophesied of for dispensations. And finally we got to see the works of God revealed and the start of the plan of salvation, the start of the knowledge of our redemption. And I'm grateful for Christ. I'm grateful for his ability to heal, his ability to make us more than what we are, to enable us. I think of all the blessings that God has given me in this year, and I'm grateful for that. I'm grateful for Rebecca. I'm grateful for all the opportunities that he's given me. And I testify that he lives and that he loves us all, and that he knows us individually. He knows the ills of our hearts, and he knows what brings us joy. And I'm grateful that he has been an active part in bringing joy to my life. And I say this in the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Peter.
Anybody else?
Okay.
Well, I've enjoyed the Light the World campaign too, and as we've done it this month, it's really, I think, helped me to focus on the Savior as a friend to everyone, and all the days he'd have you do things like, see things like Jesus honored his mother, Jesus fed the hungry, Jesus clothed the naked, all of these compassionate things, everything that we did, I think all the days, it was something outward, something that took you outside of yourself, even if just in your thoughts of getting outside of your own bubble and thinking of others and lifting others and making efforts on their behalf, whether doing something physically or even just praying or being aware of the needs of others. And I love that. I love the attention it brought to that, because I think that's who the Savior is our friend. Friend to everyone in the world, and a friend no matter where you are on your spiritual journey, or whether you're on or off, he's your friend, and he's my friend, and I know that he wants me to be the best version of myself that I can be, and he wants that for everyone else. And I look at my kids and I know how much I want everything good for them. And I know the Savior wants that for me and for them and for all of us so much more. So much that he not only gave his life, but that he lives and he guides us and he helps us now, so that if we seek him, we can have that help. And I know he will give it to us. And he will help us to feel his love for us, and he will help us to feel his love for others. And he will help us to know and to be confident in the good things we're doing. Because I think a lot of times we get down on ourselves thinking of what we're not. But I know the Savior sees us for who we are, who we can be, and he can help us to see that in ourselves as well. And I say that in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
One Feed the Hungry Day, a mommy was gonna share animal crackers
gonna give a whole pack of animal crackers to this homeless guy, and his sign said, I'm hungry, but then he said no to them, and he turned them down. So it totally ruined her Feed the Hungry thing.
It's a true story.
She tried.
I had gone to Walmart, I was gonna make this recipe, and I needed animal crackers, and I had gone, and it was crazy at Walmart.
Oh, there's always those panhandlers outside of Walmart.
I got off the exit to go back into Kay's about 200 north, mm-hmm. and he was on the corner there, and I saw him, and his sign said in big letters, I'm hungry, please help, I'd rather beg than rob, something like that. I was like, and then I thought of the thing for the day, Jesus fed the hungry, and I was like, oh, and I had the animal crackers sitting right there. I was like, I don't want to go back to the store again. I was like, oh, I have to feed the hungry. So I rolled down the window. I was like, I'll figure out the animal crackers later. I'll go to the dollar store or something. I don't know. So I rolled down the window and said, hey, I've got this tub of animal crackers. You can have it. He's like, no, thanks, but have a blessed day.
And you're like,
okay.
You're not that hungry then.
I tried to feed the hungry, and the hungry didn't want my food.
I don't think so, Daddy.
Trying to formulate the words. There's sometimes when you feel things that you don't know have words for. But you know, the veil feels very thin sometimes, and I've been really grateful this year with the Book of Mormon, teaching it. I love teaching gospel doctrine. I don't know how much longer they'll keep me there because it's been a few years, but because I love how it draws me closer to the Savior. And helps me understand and put the puzzle pieces together, and knowing that your dad has that opportunity to serve, I envy that. That you don't have to worry about paying bills or going to work so that you can pay bills, but he can just serve now. And that's cool. But there's not a doubt in my mind that the Savior lives and that He loves us far more than we ever love ourselves. And I just hope that I can live my life so that I'm worthy of that and worthy to return home. And I know He's got a plan for everyone, whether you're active or not active, or gospel's in your life or not in your life. He loves all of us and wants us all back, and there'll be a way that that will happen. I have no doubt. And that we will be a family forever. And if it means that I keeping my covenants ensures that, then so be it. And we'll be together, all of us, forever. Probably get on each other's nerves a little, but
as long as the mansion's big.
As long as the mansion's big.
The rooms are soundproof.
Yeah. But I know He lives. I know it. It's not even it's as real as the fact that we're sitting here. I say this in the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
Amen.
Anybody else? I think we've all gone except for Rebecca and Jared.
Not everyone has to go if you don't want to.
going on, but it seems like we're about there. I think this is one of our most special traditions as a Clark family that Mom and Dad did instituted years and years ago, was to have a program like this. And it's one of the things that I look forward to the very most about Christmas time. I don't know that I ever feel closer to all of you than when we do this. So thank you. We will now sing Silent Night. And then we need closing prayer.
Peter, I said it.
Oh, Peter's going to say it.
Yeah. I'd take back. I'm
like, let's sing all three verses.
No. I don't know his name.
Second and third.
It's a good chance to learn.
This is my phone? Okay.
To give you a thank you note for Christmas, for all you did for our wedding.
Please included it with Christmas.
Oh, I know Christmas slash thank you.
And the wedding wrapping paper is so festive.
Is that, just rip it.
That's
just rip
what
it.
You have.
Oh, thank you. Mine are disgusting and need to be thrown out.
I checked your Christmas list. I checked
thank
it twice.
You.
I'm checking
this
it twice.
Right. It's our turn.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I just really needed those this year.
Yeah, they're nice.
That's
here.
Cute wrapping paper.
Yeah, I like it. Especially you.
I don't get much video with me in it on Christmas ever.
We got a box!
I love boxes.
I'm so glad you got a box.
But how do you open the box?
Mary, maybe some scissors if you see any handy.
I didn't.
They're in the junk drawer.
I haven't pulled out the cookies yet.
Yeah, we'll grab
it. It's over on the table, I think.
Okay, I'll get it.
But I think I got
Blake-ish.
It.
Oh, it's fine if you
want.
Blake-ish is gonna come tonight.
We
got it.
I would hope not.
Cabela's.
All right.
Cabela's.
The Blake-ish twin.
No, there's no announcement.
No, but I mean.
The announcement is that we're happily married.
No, I mean like the Blake-ish twin. It's one of the new people in the band.
We'd like to make an announcement.
Do that.
Yes.
Okay.
We'd like to make an announcement. We're both happily married.
The
birds are being
like,
well, I don't think the Pendletons are used to announcements on Christmas Eve.
No, that'll be so funny.
Our family is.
They're like,
socks. And I didn't put it on.
It's always the announcement time.
And I even wanted them.
Is that for me? This is for me.
No, that's for your
Star Wars socks.
These are cute. Who are these two?
Well, you and Natalie can. There's two girls' pair and
no,
then there's
a no,
boys' pair.
No way.
What's this?
Yay.
Who's this two?
Those are yours.
Who's this two? All the kids?
All of you.
That's your shirt.
Hey, Maddie, did you get socks?
Yes.
Whoa.
Is that a puzzle?
Oh, okay.
Yes.
The kids
are
doing
that would be fun to do.
That would be nice.
Swing. I like these socks.
The lifesaver booklets
good.
Are from Grandpa Clark.
Yes, they are.
No, they're not from. He didn't buy them. They're from Grandpa Clark.
From beyond the grave, he's
well, what is it?
Still showing out prisons.
I don't know. I can't get open yet. Could I keep the bow?
Hold
up. Just let me get it. Here, you keep that bow. Oh, there's two bows. That's right.
Those are cool.
Very cool.
I want the white one.
Okay,
oh, these look so cool.
I'm having
trouble opening
that.
There
we go.
Oh, that was the one
strong.
Why are we opening
that
this?
Right now.
Because
we won't see you in the morning.
Oh, that's pretty.
Oh.
What is it, Daddy?
It's
okay.
A bracelet with
the
pin.
This is mine.
This is
mine.
Is that for family?
This one.
Where life
for
comes
you.
Love
and everything.
Aww.
Hey, Daddy. It's a multi-tool.
Can I see?
Yes.
Oh, that thing does everything.
Thank you. I'm going to keep
it. I got Mickey Mouse socks.
Come on.
What is this?
I do not know.
That's their present from Grandma.
No, you can open yours now.
I opened mine yesterday.
I know.
It's my hallway.
You opened the door.
It looks old.
Two love from
Grandma.
It's
a gift card. These are awesome.
Where did you find these socks?
All right.
Well, it's practical.
I love it. Thank you.
I wish people would have given us Walmart gift cards for our wedding.
Oh,
didn't you get some?
Yeah, we did. But most people gave us Target gift cards.
I don't know why people go to Target, but
I love Target so much. Target's way better.
I like cheap stuff.
I like Target.
Thank you very much, Mom.
Well, there's
you're
one
welcome.
Green and one wild berry.
Or the gummy.
So Grandma
too.
Has given you each $20.
No. Can I have it right now?
No.
No.
How are you going to spend it on?
What are you going to do right now?
Thank you, Grandma.
Daddy, where are
your
socks?
Right
here.
Oh,
okay,
thank you.
Which one do you want?
And
to?
I didn't see your socks.
And I've got some. I've got two of them for.
I love your socks. Mr. V would like those socks.
Okay, we're opening your guys'
gifts. I've got two gifts for you I'll get after you guys are finished with that.
Yay! Those are the best
plans. Now you
can
play
Mormon
Bridge.
What?
Oh,
Amazon,
dang it. You already have Rook?
Yeah.
We don't have this,
sorry.
Though.
But we don't, this is what I wanted!
No, but Peter, more than one Rook deck comes in so handy.
Okay, we'll keep
oh, it really
or,
does. Yeah.
Or sometimes
Natalie.
You go to like Walmart and they'll let you... They'll
is that,
but we
is that with
like
the Peter and Rebecca's gift in
so
the back
right.
of the tree there by the plant?
No.
Can you check to see?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Oh, do we?
It's
yeah,
way in the back.
Gave us a bunch of card games.
Oh, that's right.
Other side.
This is gonna, it's always nice to have more than one.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Is that the gift in the blue wrapping
so
paper?
You're welcome. Oh, this one?
I'm glad you said that because
yeah, is that
I thought
is
of
that
one,
theirs?
I
but
no. Game, and then I kept asking
the one.
One day you said
yeah,
the
we
game
were at Seagull
straight.
Book, and I'm like,
look
can
straight.
We get Settlers of Catan for ourselves?
Oh, that one?
I think it's that one. Is that theirs?
Because Terry has it, and if Terry has it, we have to have it.
Oh,
Basically.
And now you have it.
Does that have their name on it?
Terry was getting married, so she had to get
it. Okay.
This is your birthday gift.
That's one part of it.
She made that.
That's insane.
She wanted to come in.
It's not very fancy.
Here you go.
It is
fancy.
Not very.
Because did you see ours?
Gosh.
I just wrote in gold Sharpie on your thing.
Wait, is that for Peter? This is for New Year's Eve. I want you to see this for New Year's Eve.
Peter got his favorite candies, and he knew that
you
would like it.
This is for New Year's Eve.
Perfect!
Oh, this is so you can complete the New Year's Eve challenge.
Okay.
Aww.
Okay, let's do this one.
Ready?
Okay.
I like my socks. I like my socks.
Me too.
Oh, Mom, yours are cute.
I like mine.
Oh, there's a plethora of gifts in there.
They look like you. I'm afraid of his elbows right now.
No, you do not have them right now.
This is all. From Dad. How's it from Dad?
Oh, he has long arms.
From beyond the grave. He's writing your mom's handwriting now.
He always loved lifesaver booklets. You got them every year.
Oh, there's one for you and for me.
Put the trash where the trash goes.
Oh. You don't have to share.
I need to do my booklet.
Or you could.
I'm guessing these are
Stop eating the candy. We're going to have cookies.
Oh, they're fun Christmas socks.
That's Becca's.
Yeah, I was like,
those
don't
fit
me.
Those
are so cute.
What did they say?
Bottoms up.
Oh. Where'd you find these?
I'm gonna put
Target.
Oh,
there we go.
Target.
Now the
one.
Where
it wanted to be. I got
a little Santa.
That's
Nick Santa. OMG,
nice
so ugly.
Because I'm always
so
cold,
cool.
So they go up extra
high. Thank you, Mom.
This one's for you. Oh, I'm
going to
open mine.
I'm putting on my socks.
I'm
just letting
you know.
These are
as old as
I think it's 1,000.
Oh, we love 1,000 pieces.
After the weekend we spent trying to do that puzzle, your kids can finally compete for real. That was fun when I challenged them. Cupcake for the...
Aaron, you're not the only one toting knives. I got one too.
Oh, these are so comfy.
This is good. We need this. We need this.
Oh, it's okay. I want to watch.
Thank you.
Them open theirs. I'll open it in just a minute. Okay.
I want to.
I can't. Open it.
I think I know what it is.
Oh.
I knew it!
We have Mackie!
What is it?
It's a bracelet.
Oh, it's so cute. What does it say?
Yeah.
Oh.
You should wear it all and say, you are now my slave.
You are now my
wear
slave.
Wear this and you will be my slave.
Slave off.
Nine bracelets she gave.
That's
one
right. Now I've got you all.
Hey, where are the scissors?
Thank you so much,
Peeps.
Mom.
You're welcome.
Daddy, where are the scissors?
I don't know.
They're right here.
Thank you, Mom. I appreciate
You're
it.
You're welcome.
Yeah, don't cut your socks. Be careful.
Thank you for saying baby.
Sorry.
Fixation.
I've never had
this,
silk hat.
Is this from? Is this from
Friday.
This from you? Oh, Mom, you did it! You did it! You got it! I know what it is already! Yay!
Well, I tried to pat it because I don't want it to get.
I know.
What is it?
I just want to see it.
I like gummy lime flavors so much better than regular lime.
What is it?
It's a picture of Jesus, I hope.
But which one?
He'll slightly recognize the picture.
It's my favorite one!
It is yours!
It's my favorite one.
I like that one because he's smiling.
Yeah, it's the only one he's ever smiling. Thank you so much, man. We got
Darren.
One.
I asked brother.
There's a...
You, why are you taking your bows out of here?
I'm
going to
try a purple one.
No. You can't be bad or good.
You're so good at wrapping presents. Peter puts so much care.
Been wrapping them for decades.
Like, I have practice.
Oh,
that's so cute.
What is it?
What?
Oh.
Alicia, that's so great.
Thank you.
Very sweet.
You love it, don't you?
Yeah.
It's like a little marshmallow man.
I like how you're destroying everything.
We should have
another congratulations tonight.
I'm gonna
put the family gift. I didn't do individual.
Here.
We got two ornaments.
There's a, yeah, there's a card that goes with that ornament.
Oh, we should have got you an ornament too.
You should write the year.
I got my siblings the ornament.
The card goes with the ornament.
I got them different. A couple of my siblings I got one.
Hi, Aunt Alicia.
Hi.
That's wow. Wow. Where are the socks you wore here? Did you wear any here?
No.
Wow.
Neither did I.
You wrote it all by hand.
I did.
So.
I always wear socks. Except in the summer. But even in the summer, sometimes I wear socks.
Where's the
pants? I like socks.
We're not going to
back
in
the...
My feet are always cold. We did that
double wrap.
The other day.
What? Oh, it's popcorn.
Ah,
is it
real?
Inside of
is
this?
It goes with the... Home video.
We got red vines. We don't like Twizzlers. Well, you don't like Twizzlers. Wait, do you like Twizzlers?
I like them. I like them. They're doing joy with your home videos this year.
Thank you.
Did you have them?
The family I have, I'm super excited about. Nathan and Nicole.
Their wedding video.
I'm FaceTiming him and having Leanne record it.
I can't wait.
Because I spent months on their gift.
Sorry. Oh, that's so nice. Thank you, Rebecca. I mean, Alicia. I'm sorry, I've got a headache right now.
Got Rebecca on the brain. Yeah.
And
that's my default setting.
Well, I get Rebecca open the bottom part there.
Yeah. You open this one.
Rebecca.
It's gonna be good.
It's your first year as a
kid. Oh my god! So cute.
Wow.
It's really, thank you so much, Lisa.
Thank
it's
you.
So nice. I know these are expensive to print.
You just sounded like Miranda Sings.
So, it's the wedding album.
You're like the blonde Miranda. Well, no, you're not.
My sister was Miranda.
That face was.
Yeah. Oh, we don't. Her.
Okay, I guess I'm supposed to open
my sister
up
was
the
her for Halloween
one from.
She has darker hair.
Yes.
And like,
you do a good
yes.
Miranda.
So exciting.
Okay.
I think I know what this
down.
Is.
Sit down and don't step on
do you
food.
Spread it? Put it on donuts?
It brings
how
cheer
do you know
to
what it
everyone
is?
Within
because
the earshot.
How could you tell?
Okay, Tony, down, down.
Tone it down.
Rise up.
I am on the tone it down.
Tone it down.
Not me, I'm on the rise
thank
up.
Thank you.
Committee.
That's awesome.
No,
this is like a year's worth of Nutella for me.
It's
about
2 months
my
later.
Thank you. You guys do have a family gift for me under the tree as well.
Really?
That's a really pretty car.
Set up, he's coming to town.